Hello fans, and today we are continuing the story of Daisuke Uchiha. Last time we saw his character development and his journey through depression after the death of his pet dog Kuro. Then one day he pays a visit to the cemetery where he falls in love with a girl named Sayu. A few weeks later, Daisuke and Sayu started dating and it was the first time Daisuke felt so content in his life. It was like he had found the candle that would kindle his life forever. He no longer felt lonely and was really happy by the companionship of Sayu. Months passed and Daisuke's attachment with her kept on rising. He was certain that she was the one for him, but still he kept this relationship private from his family. Little did he know that these moments of love will soon disappear as Sayu was slowly losing interest in him because of his introverted and arguably boring nature. It was the 8th month of their relationship and Daisuke was now planning to introduce Sayu to his family. But things didn't go as planned. It was weekend and Sayu didn't visit the cemetery like she usually did and Daisuke got concerned as he knew she was a really punctual person. So he went to his place but her mother told him that she hasn't returned home since morning. Worried about Sayu, Daisuke sneaks into the Konoha security system and looks at live CCTV footage throughout the village. And after looking for half an hour, he finally finds Sayu, but shockingly enough she was with another guy. All the seemingly fruitful moments of joy that he spent with Sayu turned grey and there was nothing that he could now look forward to. The whole world around him turned blank and the grief of losing someone he found special awakened his Mangekyo Sharingan. Meanwhile, Jigen ordered his inner Kara members to find more vessels for the Operation Karma Seal. But this time he asked them to look for someone who has a heart filled with shattered hopes. That night, an inner Kara member Code, who was wandering around Konoha outskirts, saw something unusual. It was Daisuke, son of Sasuke Uchiha, torturing a boy with his Tsukuyomi technique. "How did you even come near to Sayu?" Daisuke kept asking and the boy kept screaming. But after a few hours of constant torture with Genjutsu, Daisuke let the boy go as his eyes started to bleed due to the overuse of the Mangekyo. He felt like everything was turning dark around him and this darkness will stay forever. But just before he could even move, someone hit him really hard on his head and he fell unconscious. When he woke up, he found himself in a lab while his vision was perfect like before. As he tried to remember what had happened, suddenly Code appeared in front of him and explained how he found him. Daisuke confessed that guy was the one his girlfriend was secretly dating and when he came to know about it, he just couldn't stop himself from doing what he did without thinking that he could have gone blind due to the overuse of his unique dojutsu. Code assured him that he needed not to worry as they had placed a special type of contact lens in his eyes that will stop the side effects of Mangekyo Sharingan from occurring. He then took Daisuke to Jigen who brainwashed him by telling him that this world is a rotten place and the life that all these humans are living is miserable. Daisuke agreed and added that there is possibly no way to end the misery of this world. Jigen then asked him if there would be a way to end this world and its sufferings once for all. Would he be willing to take a part in the progress? Daisuke replied by saying he has seen enough at such a young age. And now he doesn't want to live like this pathetic world anymore. And if there is really a way to stop all this, then he, Daisuke Uchiha, will certainly sacrifice whatever it takes for the sake of the innocent people whose whole lives have been full of struggles and failures. Jigen then revealed his true identity and his plan to destroy the whole world. Daisuke, who was feeling weakened, quickly agreed upon his plan and lets him bestow a karma on him. The next morning, Sakura had a nightmare about her son being eaten by a monster. She becomes worried as Daisuke had not returned home last night. Sakura quickly contacts Ino and asks her to see if Daisuke is in the village by the tracing system. Ino informed Sakura that Daisuke's last traces were around the outskirts and then he mysteriously vanished from there. Sakura got even more worried and quickly contacted Naruto and Sasuke explaining them the whole situation. Naruto sent a team of 7 jonin ninjas outside Konoha to search for Daisuke. Sarada, after realizing her brother had gone missing, reached Boruto and asked him to accompany her to find Daisuke. They both planned to leave the village but as soon as they reached a forest around the outskirts, Sasuke appeared out of nowhere in front of them and asked them to not go any further as they would be called rogue ninja if they did it without permission. Boruto told Sasuke that they want to find Daisuke, to which he replied they are not sure if someone kidnapped him or if he has willingly gone rogue. With a shocked expression on his face, Boruto kept looking forward, and when Sasuke turned around to see what's there, it was his son, with strange markings all over his body. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. For now, this will be the final part of this story, as I have got some new concepts and ideas to work on. Subscribe if you wanna watch them first. Do tell me in the comments if you'd like to see more of these stories in the future. I will see you in the next one.